Previously on the Uncarrier.
If you landed from Mars on this planet and you looked at the way people sell to customers in this industry, you would get back in your spaceship and go where you came from.
People ask us, where do we get these ideas? And it's really simple.
We're listening to the customer and solving their pain points. You can upgrade when you want, not when you're told to.
A family plan is nothing more than a contract on super steroids. And it's not Joe Schmo pulling down porn that's the problem. Customers tell me repeatedly, I wish I could switch, but I'm handcuffed. I want every customer to have constant, complete choice.
This is the end of contracts.
We think everybody should cheat on their carrier. The bad guys are now coming up with their fear, uncertainty, and doubt as to why T-Mobile is doing this. My answer is why the fuck not? This is not a diving Hail Mary pass for us. We are growing like crazy. 300 million pops of LTE by the end of the year. We are moving to a bigger, broader, faster, wider network than AT&T or Verizon.
We've got a strategy, a team, and a brand that are on fire.
Everything we do is designed to change the entire industry. We are not going to stop. Now, you didn't think I was done, did you? Uncarrier 10. Yeah. Listen, we got a lot of people in on the video, so happy to everybody that's here. Welcome to everybody that's here. Welcome to the loud and proud T-Mobile frontline here and on the dial-in. Let me just see if there's any T-Mobile people here. Okay. All right, now I also want to have a special shout out to the thousands of people from AT&T and Verizon who have been assigned by their executive team to watch everything we do. And then I want a special shout out to everybody at Sprint who's been assigned to watch everything we do and copy it by tomorrow. That is the... I specifically want to shout out to Randall, to Glenn, to... Who's that other guy in the middle? Ralph. Did I forget any of the other CEOs of AT&T? I think we got them all. You want to be a CEO of AT&T? I passed that shit up a long time ago. So, Uncarrier 10. X marks the spot. Hey, there you are. X marks the start. You know what? It's been a while since we've done an Uncarrier move, like March or so. We're not going to wait that long for the next one, though. We take these Uncarrier moves very seriously. We want to make sure that it creates significant industry change. Remember, I just want to remind everybody, when we started this whole game, we started with a manifesto. We stood for something. The Uncarrier stood for solving customer pain points to fix a stupid, broken, arrogant industry, not to differentiate ourselves by the move itself, but by causing everybody else to move. And I'm going to reflect on that in a second before I announce the move. But I want to remind you what I promised you before, and I promise you again, we won't stop until all this change is done. And the best part is Dumb and Dumber are making this so fucking easy for me. It's incredible. I'm sorry. The young guy over here, one of our top future journalists, this winner, he's far too young to hear this shit, so block your ears now. There you go. They're making it easy. I particularly want to thank Randall for putting the lawyers on his customers lately. That was free food. But I will tell you, there are some things that aren't changing yet. And there's a reason they're not changing, and that's what we're going to talk about today. And in spite of the fact that I flew planes over their buildings after 330,000 of you told us that overages should stop, they haven't stopped. Despite $2 million bills are still going out to customers, and there's a reason, and I'm going to talk about that reason today. But I've got a lot on my mind. There are a bigger set of problems. Dave, hold on to this. Don't sip it. I've got germs. There you go. These things, these devices, even in the time we've been together. Roger, how long have we been doing this together now? A few years. When was it you and I got thrown out of that party? By the way, it was a shitty party anyway. Wait till you see the party tonight. But there are... Yeah. Okay. But we've been watching these devices change right before our eyes. And simply, as I said before, as all content is going to the internet and all internet is going mobile, it's happening right in front of us. But the problem we have is Dumb and Dumber have customers right where they want them. And they're going to leverage these positions with customers for selfish gain. They've got greed in their eyes, and I don't want this to sound like a supervillain movie, but it is. It really is a big problem, but we're going to do something about it. Customers are living in fear or in shock of their bills. This is a big deal, and I'm pissed. And when I get pissed, it keeps me awake at night. And when I stay awake at night, we think of shit to do. And I'm declaring today Data Day, D-Day. Everything I'm going to do today has to do with Uncarrier moves, AMP moves associated with the growing problem associated with data. We're going to take this revolution to the next level, and we are going to disrupt the scam starting now. And I'm telling you, this is... Okay, quick reminder. What we're about is changing wireless for good. 3 years ago, there was no Uncarrier One. Okay? 3 years ago. Now, so much has... Now, I'm not taking full credit, or T-Mobile taking full credit for what's changed. Only roughly 99% of it. I'm sure there's been some small innovation along the way. But what happens here is we help cause change and people follow. So, how about this, though? Seriously. Go back 2.5 years before Uncarrier One. Contracts. Everybody had contracts. I remember the first time that I met Roger, first time I met some of you, no contracts was a fantasy. It was a fantasy. In fact, when I told my board what we were going to do, I think that they pissed themselves before everybody else. By the way, do you remember some of you when you thought this cost $99, except when it was on sale? Right? Even the rose gold, Roger, 99. Okay? 122 million people now are free of contracts thanks to the Uncarrier. And by the way, even Verizon has come around. And with the first change that we made, we separated devices from rate plans so there's full transparency. Then we moved on to this. 57 million Americans can upgrade anytime they want instead of every 2 years, which was what the bullshit was before we started this game. Right? Now, everybody does. Right? It's not just us. There's Edge, there's Next, there's iPhone for eternity life or till we go out of business. And these are all because we showed it was possible and then customers demanded it. EIP, lease programs, these are new. It's freedom for customers. Here's my favorite. Remember early termination fees? I remember a lot of you told me, hey, John, I love what you guys are doing, but I can't come. I'm stuck. So the concept used to be that people paid carriers to get out. Now, the carriers have paid over $1 billion out in porting credits and termination fees to customers. Customers have been paid $1 billion to do what they prayed they'd be able to do, and we only announced carrier freedom in January of 2014. So change of a huge scale is possible. How about this? This is real data. The cost of a gig of data has gone down 62%, okay? And that's before we get innovative about how you use data. 62% more affordable. Now, let me just tell you, and this is the funny part. When I do these announcements like today, there's two things that happen at once. Customers are gonna love this, right? But until I show and explain it in detail, investors are scared. Holy shit, wireless wars. They're giving stuff away again. DT, why'd you let that guy on the loose? He's fucking it up, right? We're not stupid. Most of what we do is stopping the way the other guys are doing it because they egregiously are doing it that way to take huge profits to themselves and invest them in other businesses. Most of the carriers in the US don't even want to be in this business. But they're stuck. And there's one way they can get out: hand their customers to us one at a time. And we're perfectly willing to do it. So here's the deal. Shocking. Shocking news. When you ask customers what they want, and you give it to them, they love it. Okay, now I've been divorced twice, but any of you that are married, this is a good way to run a marriage. It took me a long time. If you're married, ask your wife what she wants, get it for her. She'll love you. I screwed that one up. You still married, Roger? See, Roger was off to a bad start, by the way. On the first night of his honeymoon, he sent me a photo of his new wife in a T-Mobile t-shirt that I sent to him. This is not what you're supposed to be doing, okay? I can't say anything else, but trust me, son, okay? Ixnay on the e-shirt, Tay, all right? Sorry, Roger. So, freedom to switch, never greater. And by the way, I didn't cover Simple Global, Tablets Unleashed, Test Drive, Music Free. Do you know how many songs we're streaming free on Music Freedom a day now? Drum roll. 200 million. 200 million songs a day. Latest statistics suggest that 197 million of them are Bruno Mars. That's how we selected him for this evening. Okay, so that's what's going on. By the way, I just want to point one thing out, especially for my employees that have been through this ride. In 2011, T-Mobile was listed in the top 10 brands that will likely soon disappear. That just came out last week, I think. I think CNET, no, I'm only kidding, Roger. I don't think they were on it. I guess they're wrong. Here's why I think they're wrong. 28 million customers have come to T-Mobile. 62 million and growing. 62 million, okay? And particularly, I'll make this easy for Randall and for Lowell. Lowell might have nodded off by now, but somebody give him a wake up. 10 quarters in a row over a million net additions to the customers. 5 out of 7 of the last quarters over 2 million. 10 quarters in a row of positive porting. It's working, right? Now, this is an easy chart. Everybody gets this, right? How much of the growth in the industry in postpaid phones has T-Mobile gotten? All. It's easy. All. Okay, here's a stat. For the last 11 quarters, this is possible, by the way, T-Mobile for the last 11 quarters has 102% of the growth of the industry. That's like if you put 10 phones on the table and 4 carriers tried to get those 10, and T-Mobile got 11. Okay. Right? That's the deal. By the way, it's even more fun. In the last 3 quarters, we've gotten 149% of the growth. In the last quarter, we got 126% of the growth. How about this for a fun? So far this year, it's only 3 quarters. Right? This year, here's the score. Other three, Molari and Shemp. Shemp always was my favorite. Molari and Shemp. Negative 900,000. T-Mobile, positive 2.6 million. Now. Right. Okay, so how's it going before I announce some new things? Postpaid porting last quarter was 1.8. It was 1.33 with Verizon. It was 2 with AT&T, and it was about 2.1 with Sprint, give or take. By the way, that's the ninth quarter in a row we've been over 2-1 with Sprint. Okay. So, but that was a good quarter, right? So how's it going so far this quarter? All I can tell you is about the last 10 days or so, or about right now. The 1.8 became 1.9. Verizon's 1.3 became 1.4. Okay. AT&T's 2 became 2.1-ish, and Sprint's up to about 2.2 to 2.3. So it's going pretty well, but I figure, what the hell, we should talk about some new things. This is the network. Remember that commercial? Ooh, sorry. Verizon. Oh, wait. I wish I could do that again. 302 million pops, 176 million pops of low band, and I have the distinguished honor of being the only CEO that won't sit up here and lie through his ass that he's not going to the low band spectrum auction. I'm going, satchels packed, and I hope none of the peckers show up. Because we know how to deploy this. Now, I do want to celebrate something, and I told Neville he should be so proud of this. Verizon. That unbelievable, gigantic corporation, one of the biggest companies in the world. They, who used to be the, hey, you know, we're the only one with a good network, just come to us. And they screwed it up a little bit. Remember they had to announce XLT? What XLT was, we let our network get slow, we better invest some money. Holy shit, here come those other guys. Now, you know what they're doing? They are spending a shitload of cash on a program of ads. You ready? Hey, we have a better network. Why would you have to say that? What happened to old Verizon? Did somebody's network get better and scare you? Why do you need that backup quarterback? And by the way, if your network's so good, why are the last 10 seconds of the ad, and if you don't believe us and you left, we'll pay you a shitload of money to come back in credits, and really, everything will be fine. Trust me. And, by the way, we want to be more human. We want to talk like people because we are people. Unreal. I'm limited to amount of the F word use, and I'm over my limit, so I left that one out. But you know what? I take this as a badge of honor. And on the network front, as well as every other front, we won't stop. So let's do some new things. How about this? Everything started with simple choice. Everything. Today we're going to amp it up. Simple choice was the start of this whole thing. It's so easy. Right? How many lines? How much data? Very simple. And at the same time, what we did was we said, hey, thanks for coming to the T-Mobile store. We can have two conversations. What device do you want? Okay, good. And by the way, we will give you interest-free financing for that. Now let's go over here. Because we spend a shitload of money on network, so let's talk about network. Easy. How many lines do you want? 50, 30, 10, 10, 10. One of you, 50. Next person, 30. 10 for the next one, 10, 10, 10. Pretty easy. I can figure that shit out. If I can figure it out, it's pretty easy. Then how much high-speed data do you want? And then the high-speed data buckets were 1, 3, 5, unlimited. Well, I think we should amp it up, make it a little bit bigger. We're now going to double the data bucket in every plan. Yeah. Double the size of the data. Okay, this is a series of moves we're going to make. Today, I'm doubling your data, and I'm introducing something called Family Match, which you're really going to like. So let's just break these things down. Simple choice, 1, 3, 5. Oops. 2, 6, 10. Okay, now, is there anybody that can't follow this so far? Okay, I know it's a little early to be drinking. For you. Okay, so, you asked, we delivered. Now, how about this? When the whole family decides to do things together. See, we learned. We did 4 gigs for, 4 for 100, 4 gigs. You know, we did the 10 gigs for all, 4 10 gigs, whatever the hell Mike calls it. He confuses me all the time. But families like to do a couple of things. They don't like to share. I never shared shit when I was a kid, right? They don't like to share. So what we also found, they all like their own bucket. But what we've decided to do, that if a family decides to move up to a higher tier together, we will do it at no cost, no increase, double, right? So this, Mike's going to come up and explain this. It's really good. But let me tell you how it ends up happening. If they go from a 2 gig to 6 gig altogether, okay? So we have a special we're going to announce too. But think about it, 50, 30, 10, 10. And then you've got the family moving from 2 to 6 at half the price, no extra from what it was before. This double plan is exactly the same as before. Now, no sharing. So that means, which we're going to get to in detail, it's not the whole family fights over 6 gigs, which is what you do at Verizon for $140, four people climbing all over each other, 5 gigs for $150 or so on AT&T. It's actually going to ultimately be $120 for four people with the promo to do 6 gigs of data for each person in the family. And then there's more news to add to this. But a small commercial, easy. Sharing is evil. Got it? It's evil. Do you remember I told you that family plans were the biggest ill in this industry? Family plans were contracts on steroids. Well, we killed that. But this is like whack-a-mole. It pops up. It's here again. It's sharing. This is the new evil. Wait till I explain it to you. People hate sharing their data. I hate sharing anything. Now, the reason this is a big problem is sharing data equals overages and overbuying. Hashtag no sharing data. Stop. 103 million people on shared schemes at Verizon and AT&T. And they're all sitting there now saying, you got my attention. Nobody wants to be your family. Do you want to police the family's use of data? What, are you going to have daily meetings to see who's using things? Okay, now, I introduced you to Joe Schmo Jr. last time we're together. Now, he needs a little adult supervision because he's, you know, he's surfing porn. And he's taken down the whole deal. So maybe Joe needs a little, but most families don't want to, you know, they don't want to sit around and police each other's data. It's a scheme, right? Now, they want it to be confusing and complex, and here's why. It's a catch-22, and they win either way. Customers never win. You buy too little, you get hit with overages. You buy too much, you overbuy, and they confiscate it. Let me give you some numbers. This is the piece that should make you sick. This is why I can't sleep, and we're announcing shit today. $2.4 billion is the amount of overages that will be charged in 2015. I turn your eyes to the counter up in the right. That's overages. As we speak, see the numbers spinning? Those are overages, right? And if you in the back there are surfing porn, and you're not on T-Mobile, you're going here. Let me help you. $274,000 an hour, $6.6 million a day, $46 million a week, $200 million a month. Here's the worst part. How long have I been fighting to get rid of overages? Year over year increased. Anybody want to know? 2015 versus 14, it's up 60%. They've got you right where they want you. Even better, do you know, versus 2013 and 2015, Verizon has charged overages to twice as many people this year as they did 2 years ago. So, you know that plane that went over their building that said abolish overages? Do you know why they pulled the shades down? Right here. What do you think the margin is on overages? It's pure. It's total. 60% increase this year. How about this? 25% of AT&T and Verizon customers say they've been hit with overages in the last 6 months. I'm pretty sure I got an audience, right? It's getting worse. Overage charges are now the number one most hated thing in the industry, $2.4 billion. Try this. Okay, 26% of people that get hit with overages say, well, shit, I better buy more data. Not saying they do, but they say that's what they would do. That $2.4 billion is a drop in the bucket that we're already trying to attack. Overbuying. That's it. $45 billion a year is confiscated after you don't use it in 30 or 60 days. $45 billion. So the 26% of the people that get an overage, what do they do? They buy shit they don't use. Okay? So do you know any other industry in the world that makes you guess and then screws you either way? Now, this is a big problem which we're going to start to solve. How about this one? I had to throw this one in. Do you know what a line access fee is? Did any of you ever decide, woke up one morning and say, oh, shit, what a nice day to go buy a line access fee? No? It's insane. $24 billion. You know what it is? Here's what it is. Everybody ready? Okay. Hi. I'm Mr. Verizon. I know this is the first day of it look cool, but hey, I'm inside here anyway. Okay. I'm going to sell you an 18-gig family plan for $100. Pretty good, huh? Oh, you want to use it? Yeah, you didn't say you could use it. There's 18 gigs of data right there. Nah, nah, nah. Yeah, okay, who wants to use it? You, $20. 20, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. Okay, come on. Hey, what's that in your hand? That's my tablet. Nope, no tablets. You want it in your tablet? $10. Are you shitting me? Is this the best gig? And what do you see in the big commercial? 100, XXL, or whatever the fuck it is. Scam, trickery, opportunity. Here's it is. Everybody love this? Now, come on, when we start to solve this, you know what's going to happen. 57% of the postpaid base at AT&T and Verizon are being hit with these. Here's the big problem. Kids, it didn't even get warmed up yet, and it's by design. It's a catch-22. Oops! That's my favorite part of the whole show, right there. Did you see that? This is mobile video. So, the data usage on these devices is going up. Average use of a device has gone from about 1.6 to 3.4 gigs now. However, the use of video as the top application is popping through the roof. 2.5 times growth already, right? And the curve is tilting. Now, customers should be celebrating this, but they're not. They're scared to death. Penalties have them petrified, which is why this is day-to-day. So here's a couple of things. I'll be serious for a second. Customers have a huge increasing appetite for new and innovative ways to use their smartphones and devices. Content has an intense, you know, and media-rich format. And I think what's been happening in my mind that I've been watching is this industry evolution is changing. If you watch where it's going, what I see is this. There's these amazing movies and shows being created, content being created, but it's being created for this. For movie screens, for TVs. And then we're all down here going, hey, that's pretty cool. I want to look at that on this. All content is going to the internet, and then I'm trying to get it mobile. There's a disconnect, and there's a huge pain point. The video that goes, it's not made for this, and it's been bothering me. A big, big, big portion of data is wasted. It's needlessly, look, it's needlessly wasted. And the big guys love this. They want to jam that shit at you so huge that you take what you want, but it rolls the meter and you pay overages as big as they are. But wasted data is ultimately bad for the industry, bad for everybody, bad for the country. It ultimately slows down networks. Speed and latency changes. Customers want reliable video. It's a big, big pain point. So one of the things that occurred to me is, can I find a way to stream in a way that gives an incredible experience but doesn't waste things? Can I optimize video for the mobile device? I want it beautiful. I want it. You guys have a good idea of what kind of stuff I watch on my phone, right? I want a DVD quality smiling at me, and I want to force the carrier's hands to stop overcharging and using fear-based selling. Because what I like to do is I like to innovate and change profit pools, and then I like to give them to my customers. So I asked Neville and I asked Abdul, who's our top technical guy, can you figure this out? And we've been working on it for the longest time. Wait a minute, sorry about this. The problem with holding your phone is people can always get a hold of you. Let me just see what this is, sorry. Oh yeah, Aaron Paul. Right, I'm a little busy. Okay. Yeah, I'm here.
John, hey, it's Aaron. Listen, I just want to apologize for the leaks. It was me. I'm gonna unfriend Evan Blass. I mean, for sure. Listen, I just wanted to say I hope you're not mad, and I hope we're still on for Thursday. Okay, my place. Season 2 of Scandal. I didn't watch any of the shows without you, I promise. Listen, I'm gonna let you go. Go back to the thing you're doing. But call me, okay? Seriously, don't be pissed. All right. I love you.
So, some of you may have guessed right. So let me launch what we're talking about here with this video. Free. Binge on. Yeah. Start watching your shows. Stop watching your data. We are so excited about this. With Binge On, by the way, if you couldn't catch it as it was going through, you can stream video without using any of your high-speed data bucket. And we're starting, and I use that word, with 24 of the most popular leading brands listed here. Many of them are here in the room. Thank you very much for being here. I won't point you out for fear of security. Mike may point you out later. This is open to any service that wants to come. Anyone that can meet our technical criteria, we will include. We'll take nominations from customers as well. And I'll save you the question. This is not a net neutrality problem, okay? This is similar to music freedom. It's free. The providers don't pay, the customers don't pay, and most important, what I'm gonna tell you about is you can shut it off. It's complete customer choice. Now, outside of the 24 starting people and then the bunch that comes, by the way, 95% of all music streaming has ultimately joined Music Freedom, and we would expect a similar avalanche coming soon. But Binge On, you can also stream 3 times as much data on anything else you want. I mean, that's just what ends up happening here. So what we've done is we've optimized the video stream, and I point this out. By the way, when you came in, right, and you saw the wall of iPads, that's the quality of what you'll get. This is DVD quality or better, but optimized not to use useless amounts of data. It's proprietary to us. It's going to force me to pay Neville a shitload of money to stay with us and not go somewhere else. But I'm very happy to do that because he really doesn't make that much already. And there is an on-off switch, right? So this offer is huge. And as usual, as Mike will point out, it's free. It is the only pricing mechanism we generally know at T-Mobile. It's free. So why are we doing this before I turn over? Okay? We happen to have some millennials in the group. Anybody here a millennial? Do you know if you're a millennial? You don't even... You're just becoming one, Kyle. You're like 14, right? It's going to run this company. But by then, we'll own all the other ones, so it'll be a really big company. Okay? So, millennials. Remember that stream of consciousness with the content? Millennials already. 57% of what they watch on a mobile device or a tablet. They don't watch television. They don't even know what that word means. You know, they're not cord cutters. And, it, you know, the word cord cutter has evolved from somebody that doesn't have fixed line telephone to be somebody that doesn't have cable TV. And then they cut out and they go over the top. They're called a cord cutter. These folks are cord nevers. They never had it. 57%. By the way, the TV industry is changing. There are 500,000 less TV subscribers than there were last quarter. There's still 97 million, but cord cutting is up 60% since 2010. Customers want to watch whatever they want to watch, where they want to watch it. Now, here's an interesting factoid. Binge watching. Aaron Paul invited me over to watch a whole season of Scandal. 84% of millennials say that they sit down and they watch more than 3 episodes at a time. But by the way, we're all catching up. You know, even to the right of baby boomers, where Dave Carey is, they still, in the nursing home, they binge watch. Okay? By the way, half of these millennials binge watch once a week. And by the way, this is going up as accessibility goes up. And it's everywhere. But here's the trick, kids. This is what's happening to video data usage. And by the way, I actually think this number's off by half. You know, when we do these kind of events, we have to source somebody. This is below what the data says. I'm telling you, it's going to be double. And the duopoly has been waiting for this moment. They've got you right where they are. Now, I don't know what they're going to do with what we say, but try this one. With this data usage trend, if you have XXL as a family on Verizon, and it's there, and it's all in the middle, and you all pay that shitload of money, and you come in, okay, based on this data usage, you will run out of XXL in 21 days. And you will pay a minimum of $126 worth of overage penalties. That's at this rate, not double that rate. That's what is planned. So let me help you. Go 90. Why was Verizon creating Go 90? Did anybody ask them to do this? Did anybody say, hey, Verizon, I would love you to curate content because I really want your opinion of what I should watch, right? Lowell, you seem like such a cool guy, you know, and I know you bought AOL, and I can't wait. So Go 90. Hey, by the way, what's this got to do with their business? I mean, I know they just bought AOL, but everything else has nothing to do with that. There must be a reason. So I just thought I would share it with you. This is Lowell McAdams, millennials expert. Okay, don't take my word for it. Go 90 can extend the profitability of a smartphone customer because the more people watch, the bigger bundles they buy, and that's what we're in the business for. So data packages should go up. Average revenue per account should go up, said Lowell McAdams, millennials expert. Okay, so the dozens and dozens of Americans who have downloaded Go 90, and there could be dozens of them, I told my team to include Go 90 in Binge On and DirecTV. You know why? Just because we can. So You can now go download the 1,065th most popular app in the Apple Store, and then you can go home and put that shit on T-Mobile, and you can stream it for free. There you go. Just because we can. And even more so, Lowell, my friend, while you're sitting there yelling at somebody, what the hell are we going to do? I want to remind you, we didn't even get warmed up yet, and we won't stop. And let me introduce Chief Operating Officer Mike Sievert to come up and tell you more.
Great job. Hey, go with the clicker. All right. How's my team doing up there? Yeah. Well, you guys, if it wasn't obvious by now, this is a huge day for T-Mobile, and it's a huge day for our customers. What John just described to us is the biggest update in the history of Simple Choice since the launch of Simple Choice in 2013. Now, all in one day, what we've done here with the changes to the plans that'll be effective Sunday is we've taken the most famous plan in all of wireless, the most simple one, and we've doubled it. We've amped it from 1 gig to 2 gigs, and it has the same construct, as John said, that it's always had. That first line is $50, that second line is $30, and all additional lines, now up to 12 lines, not just 10 lines, are $10 a line, but they come with double the data, 2 gigs. The second thing we did, and this is where it really starts to get interesting, is we've doubled the data packages that go on top. So it used to be 3 gigs and 5 gigs, and now it's 6 and 10. And as John said, the mechanism that we've done to allow people to have that doubling at the same price as before is called T-Mobile Family Match. Now, the way this works is pretty simple. When the whole family gets that data package, you save huge. You not only get the doubling, but you get the doubling at the same price. Now, of course, there are some people that want to mix and match. Maybe not everybody in the family wants the same amount of data. And if that's the case, today's rate plans also have a major price reduction. In fact, a 25% price reduction when you mix and match. So double the data at the same price with Family Match, but if each person wants their own, it's now 25% less. Used to cost $20 to get 4 gigs of data. Now it's only 15 when you mix and match. Now let me translate this for you. This is where it kind of gets interesting. When you've got a family of four, it used to be that you would get 3 gigs each for $140. Now stick with me on this math, remember? 50, 30, 10, 10, that's $100 for the Simple Choice plan. Then $10 for each line to plus it up with extra data, $140 for 3 gigs each, no sharing. Pretty good deal. Most popular deal on the internet, obviously has caused us to get all of the industry growth. But what we've done today is we've doubled it to 6 gigs, so every member of the family gets 6. And John hinted at this a few minutes ago, but we're also announcing today a major promotion to celebrate the launch of Simple Choice Amped. And this is kind of where I start to sound like a knife salesman, Ginsu Knife. But wait, there's more. Because we're launching today, it's not $140 for a family of four. We're launching a major promotion that makes it $120. Because starting Sunday, the fourth line is free for every member who gets Family Match. Every family, fourth line free. That's on the 6 gigs, it's on the 10 gigs, it's on the unlimited, and it's available as a limited time promotion to celebrate the launch of Simple Choice Amped. Now let's break down how this works competitively. John mentioned Verizon. They've got extra large plans and extra large plans. This is the one at mainstream price points. 6 gigs to share, yeah, seriously, for the whole family to share. That's the one they offer at mainstream price points. Compare that to Simple Choice Amped. That's 6 gigs, not for the family, not to share, 6 gigs for you and for you and for you, plus unlimited video streaming with Binge On from the most popular services at $120. So that's what we're bringing to market starting on Sunday. Now, I want to make sure our customers know that we're not leaving out our favorite customers, those on unlimited 4G LTE. It's a big day for our unlimited customers as well. Most of you know that one of the most popular features for our unlimited customers is their ability to tether, to use a mobile hotspot feature so they can connect lots of devices to their unlimited plan. The first 7 gigs used to be good for tethering, mobile hotspot. Now we've doubled it to 14. And with Binge On, the streaming video from those popular sites never comes from that 14 gig, so it'll be there when our customers with unlimited plans want it. Plus, we're also announcing a new partnership with Vudu for a free movie rental for our unlimited customers with Binge On every single month in 2016, just as a celebration. So we love our unlimited customers. And by the way, we love them the old-fashioned way, too. We've slashed the price of unlimited for family plans with Family Match. Now it's only $180 on Simple Choice Amped for a family of four to have unlimited 4G LTE. That's our lowest price ever for unlimited. Now, we're not leaving out our business customers. The last time we were all together was Uncarrier 9. That was Simple Choice for Business and the Uncontract. And we're amping up Simple Choice for Business as well. Now, I could take 20 minutes and slice and dice it for you up to 15,000 lines, but to suffice it to say, it's double. So go online at tmobile.com and check out our business plans. Our business team is on fire with twice the sales that they had before Uncarrier 9. We couldn't be happier about today's implications for our business customers as well. So, John unveiled the big news, Binge On. Does anybody want to see the world debut of our TV commercials for Binge On? All right, have a look.
I was on the bus and I couldn't stop streaming. I didn't want to think about the overages.
It's okay. T-Mobile now has Binge On, so you can stream all the movies, TV, and sports you want without using your data. It's like free.
So it's okay that I binged an entire season during my kids' piano recital?
I've done that.
Yeah.
I'm binging right now.
You know, I think we made a real breakthrough here today.
What?
Oh, he dies in this episode.
Introducing Binge On with T-Mobile. Stream video free without using your data from Netflix, HBO Now, Hulu, and many more.
Welcome. Take a seat. Pull up an episode.
Isn't this Binge Watchers Anonymous?
It was, but then T-Mobile started letting people stream all the video they want without the shame of paying for extra data. Now we just use this room to catch up on the latest episodes.
Oh, isn't this the one where he turns into a ghost?
Seriously? Don't complain. It's free.
Introducing Binge On with T-Mobile. Stream video free without using your data from Netflix, HBO Now, Hulu, and many more.
Wait, they. All right. So, with today's big news, you got to get involved and keep track. So, I encourage everybody to go to tmobile.com/bingeon. To check out as this service evolves. As John said, we're going to be adding services all the time. And the list could change. It could add. It could grow. So go to tmobile.com/bingeon and see what's happening and which videos will stream free. I want to make sure to acknowledge that we can't do this by ourselves. It takes friends. And I want to ask my team up here to give a great big T-Mobile welcome for some of our friends. Are you ready to do that for me? Yeah. All right. So first, let me thank the folks at Sling TV. Roger Lynch, Chief Executive Officer, is here. And the folks at Netflix, Paul Perryman, Head of Business Development, is with us. And the folks at HBO, an entire team is with us from HBO. Welcome, HBO. And Tim Connolly, Head of Business Development at Hulu, is with us today. And Kimberly Wilson from ESPN, an entire team. Welcome, ESPN. Jeff Hirsch, President of Global Marketing at Starz, is with us today. And lots of other partners, so thank you for being a part of it. Now, I want to explain all the eligibility for this, and the first part is pretty simple, everyone. So there's two benefits to Binge On that John talked about. The first is that we've taken your video streams, all of your video streams, and optimized them for a mobile device. So you get a great viewing experience and way more reliable and efficient use of your data. In fact, three times more video from your data with this optimized video stream. Every single T-Mobile customer gets Binge On and triple the data. It's an incredible breakthrough. And video streams free. Free, unlimited video streaming from all of our partners starting at 24. Every single person with added data at T-Mobile. That's 3 gigs and up. everybody on Family Match, everybody on new plans, and everybody on legacy plans as well gets Binge On when you have added data for free. When does it start? It starts on Sunday for everyone on a new Simple Choice Amped plan. That's new customers and existing customers who switch to Simple Choice Amped. And it starts a week from Friday for every single customer in our base with no signups, nothing to do, no action required. You just get it for free. It comes to your plan within the next 2 weeks. Sound like a good deal? Now, as has become customary in big launch events at companies, thank you, Apple, we've got one more thing. Every single customer gets an exclusive discount that we've been able to put together with our friends at Sling TV. 30% off on Sling TV subscriptions for every single T-Mobile customer starting next week. Sound okay? Go to sling.com/T-Mobile and check it out. Now, this is the part where I want to ask everybody to get involved, because something like this, day-to-day, D-Day, it's too big to just sit and watch. Come get your part in it. And so, we're asking every one of our fans out there to become a card-carrying binger. Come to bingewatchersanonymous.org, sign up, get your membership card, post it on social, and are you ready for this? When you do, your voice, your likeness, your image could be featured in one of our national ads. You want to be in our commercials? Yeah. So come to bingewatchers.org and get involved. And now I want to ask my fellow bingers to come to the stage. John, Neville Ray, our chief technology officers, and we'll have a discussion. Thanks, everybody.
Okay. All right. Well done.
Yep.
Okay. So with that, drum roll. We would love to take any questions that you have, comments, shouts of glee.
Woo!
What about YouTube?
Yeah, you know what? We'd love to have them in. We're in discussions. And in fact, if you look across the internet, there's lots of, this is an incredible list. 24 of the most popular services, and of course there are some conspicuous missing ones. So we're going to work really hard to do the technical integration with YouTube and with every other site out there that wants to take part. What we need to be able to have, and Neville can speak to this, is we've got to be able to have really good, reliable mechanisms to identify what's video so that we can set it free. And that's really the standard of our technical requirements, which we're going to publish out on .com today. And we're ready to go. So we're just going to work with all partners that aren't in yet who want to be in and set your video free.
Moral of the story is that at this moment they didn't meet the technical requirements and or desire to, but we got this together really, really quickly. It's pretty clear that customers' voices will ask us and customer voices will ask YouTube. And if YouTube asks us, let me just give you the answer. Yes. So stay tuned. Yeah, what? You haven't all switched to Go 90? I thought it was Blow 90, but then they kind of corrected me. I thought it was a new, I don't want to say, I'll leave it there. Roger!
Yes, me.
Here you are.
Hey.
You're looking good, by the way.
Thank you.
You really are.
I don't have the velvet hood, though, so that's...
I'm pretty sure you have one somewhere. You just don't have the to wear it.
What, you mentioned Mike, actually this is a question for Mike. You mentioned that this was available for folks who have 3 gig plans or above. What about for folks who have the baseline 1 gig plan?
It's the same group, if you think about it, it's the same group that we've that gets data stash. So everyone on 3 gigs or more, that's everyone with paid data. Now remember, every single customer gets the benefit of the more efficient streaming. That's up to 3 times more video watching from your data bucket. So those people on 1 gig, 3 gig plans, those people or 2 gig plans, those people on anything that doesn't have attached data, get a huge benefit out of this. And the other thing to point out is, and this is really interesting, is that we're putting power and control into the hands of customers with this move. This is free, it's automatic, it gets added over the next 2 weeks, and you're in control. Anybody who wants can go into their mytmobile.com, turn it on, turn it off, activate it, reactivate it, and be in control at all times. So it's really a fantastic situation for every customer.
It's a great question, Roger, because first of all, the core customer you know, the $50, and then they've got 2 gigs. They were probably not binge video watchers to begin with, right? Or they would be. Now, this immediately moves them to 2. It allows them to have Binge On so that they can try a lot and see what the quality is, and then for a really simple price, we would expect a lot of people to move up. But the entry point for that stream that's optimized on the 24 providers to be free is the 3 gig. You don't really have the...
I do.
You got, like, a lot.
I'm a poor reporter. I can't make
it. You really? You have, like...
No, I have a 1 gig.
You have a 1. Well, you have 2.
Now you have 2. Two gigs.
And well, video.
See, Roger,
and video.
Hook up with me over here, and I'll give you a few sites to check out. And I trust me, after you check these out, you're gonna need a little Binge On help. I'm not saying, hey, it could be National Geographic. This is where I used to have to go when I was young.
And he's got somebody right over here.
Yeah.
Hi, David Ruddock with AndroidPolice.com. Getting some echo here. But I was wondering, I noticed the asterisk about 480p be considering DVD streaming quality. Is that going to scale with network availability and congestion and such? And how far, Skip, will it go up or down? Depending?
Absolutely. It's just the beginning. Neville, you want to jump in?
Yeah. I mean, 480p provides you, you know, outstanding quality on a smartphone. I mean, that's a great starting point. So, you know, you're going to have a great video experience on the smartphones we've got today. But that's the starting point. Going forward, I mean, there's a lot happening in the space. I look at, sorry to get too techie, but I look at new codecs, right? And I look at VP9 and H.265 and what's coming down the pike. And our ability to continue to optimize and improve the experience, right, based on codecs, new handset capabilities, will continue to, you know, improve and further optimize. So I'm excited about where we are. The quality on the phones is going to be great, but it's where we start. And going forward, it's going to get better.
Are you questioning what the quality is going to be?
I'm just curious. I'm wondering if it will scale up at all, if there's any kind of scaling going on initially, or if it's locked at 480p to start.
You got it.
Yep.
You get 2 questions for wearing that hipster shirt.
And the beard.
Yeah.
So, John, I wanted you to talk about net neutrality and what the implications are of this.
Listen, in no rank order, I make it very clear, as I always have, that we fundamentally believe in a free and open internet. We also know that the principles suggest that you don't slow down or throttle based upon content or location, et cetera, and we abide, you know, by all of those. And the principles we used in music freedom that we think are applicable here are, of course, there's no money changing hands. There's no providers paying us to do this. There's no customers paying us to do this. We're just simply not using the allocation of high-speed data for it. And then the biggest customer choice variable is you go to mytmobile.com and you go into your settings and you just shut it off or you turn it on. So it's a feature and it's complete customer choice, and we think it's directly in line. And we certainly have, you know, discussed this position as we have with music freedom. So we think it's highly net neutrality friendly.
I just add, John, I mean, I think this is all about innovation. It's about competition. It's about consumer choice. And if net neutrality is not about all of those things, what's it all about? I think there's very little to be concerned in, you know, with what we're doing here. This is liberating, not a constraint.
It's a great debate, too. And I'm looking forward to using this and all of what we've been doing to discuss this issue from a different perspective. Net neutrality has been a topic of fear for many people. They fear that this treasure that we have of the internet is going to be taken away by big, you know, companies using it preferentially to their advantage for reaping profits, which is the complete opposite of everything we do at T-Mobile. So, you know, what we stand for and how we focus on giving things to customers and giving choice to them, I think it's the fundamental underpinning of what people who think about net neutrality are concerned about. And I think this will actually not only not be a problem, I think it's going to be an example of the kind of things that, you know, advance the cause.
Last thing, a commercial for any service, large or small, that wants to get involved with Binge On. Just email one of the three of us or a new box that we've set up, bingeon@t-mobile.com. We'll get you hooked up with our team. So if you're the megacorp or you're a guy just starting out, all are welcome to Binge On.
I wanted to go on her coattails about the net neutrality argument. Doesn't this actually make the argument for proactive network management in an arena? I mean, obviously, since there's no money changing hands, the net neutrality fear-mongering kind of falls on its face because it's really driven by hatred for Comcast and Time Warner anyway. So free video, free music. Are you saying that T-Mobile does not have positive control to maintain and prioritize data on its all-data network? And do you do that? You manage voice over IP? Do you allow allocation so that there's a constant stream, things like that?
Yeah, I mean, there's no prioritization here at all, none. So this is all about optimizing video. If you know, the slides that John had, there's so much, you know, wasted overhead on data delivery today. And that's the piece that, you know, you move away from. You optimize the video so that, you know, the experience on that device is great. And that's very consumer friendly. It's also network friendly too, right?
But let's have a separate discussion about this, because it is a hot topic that I'm very comfortable and I enjoy. And I will agree with you on several things. Yes, most of the hatred in the world is focused on Comcast, et cetera. So we can agree on that. We have common ground. We're together, which is wonderful. Network management principles are net neutrality friendly, and they're used for a very positive reason. And we can, but it's often confused with other items. And remember, when you say what T-Mobile is doing to network management and prioritization, in this case, the customer is. If the customer wants to go and turn this on or off, it's a toggle. So we have created a capability and a technology. Here it is. You want it? You turn it on.
You choose it.
You manage your network and you manage your data stream. But who would we be to tell you? And if you don't want, it's like this. Pow. Off. Customer choice. So.
Jefferson Graham with USA Today. I just want to make sure I understand 480p video, lower resolution, but you wouldn't have to pay for it. I could just imagine your competitors are going to say our videos are higher resolution than theirs are.
You want to talk? I mean, my first answer to you will be check it. Go in. All we want you to do, and we're going to have places for everybody to look at it. Don't get hung up on 480p. Get hung up on, we are going to give you DVD quality or better. We're going to give you something that we've proven to ourselves that, for example, on a device, when you're holding it in your hand, it's not even discernible, right? You can't. Now, if you end up wanting to mirror to your, you know, big screen, you just turn it off, right? So the interesting part about this is I'm not going to try to convince you that what we've created is perfect. I've seen it. I want you to try it. And when you look at it and you try it and you say, holy shit, that's really good, it's free and you can turn it on or off if there's something that you want to watch that you think you'd want higher resolution on. And it is optimized for what a device needs right now. So try it. And I would expect Dumb and Dumber. Have you ever seen us announce anything where they don't come out and say, like, for example, when we announced Wi-Fi calling, the stupidest thing I ever heard was, well, you did that because you had to. Now, come on.
Year
There's
later.
A Wi-Fi signal in your dungeon. Not that I've ever been in a dungeon. But and you turn it on and you let your devices use it. Why wouldn't you? And in this case, this is a capability. If you want to watch 1080, you can. But if you see that the movies that you're downloading from Netflix or from Sling and you're watching, they're perfect, and then you think, shit, I can watch like 10 of those, and it's free. Let's have the debate.
Just on that topic, too, by the way, some of the most popular use cases on a mobile device for maximizing resolution against all other variables is for when people want to mirror it up to a big screen TV. And this technology is smart enough that it knows whether or not you're on Wi-Fi or whether or not you're on T-Mobile's network. Because people are concerned about efficiency and streaming really network efficiently when they're on their mobile network. But when they're on Wi-Fi, they may have different set of priorities. And so what the technology does is it says, look, I'm going to apply this optimization when you're on the mobile network. And when you're on Wi-Fi, which is the typical case when you're mirroring up with Apple TV or Chromecast, et cetera, it doesn't apply. It's automatic. It knows that you're on Wi-Fi.
I had the perfect slogan created last night when we were having this debate. But then, you know, older people like Neville told me that somebody had already used this slogan because I said that this is, it tastes great and it's less filling, right? I mean, the quality is great, and yes, it's optimized, which is not only good for you, but it is good for network utilization for everybody and the experience that you'll get. And, you know, and so rather than, you know, go with the fear, uncertainty, and doubt and saying, oh, wow, they slowed it down, try it. That's all I'm saying. We found something that they don't like because it won't lead to overages and penalties. Kyle.
Hello, guys. My name is Kyle Romanoff, and I'm wondering, now that music and video are mostly off the list, what other things are people going to use their high-speed data on mostly?
Now, let me explain to you who this young man is. We had a contest on Twitter, and it was, if you can convince me that you are the biggest T-Mobile fan, in whatever way you want, we will fly you to the event and give you airfare and hotel and bring you to the event. And he did a video that I sent to my entire leadership team and told them I would immediately replace any of them with this kid. It was seriously trying to figure out how to release this and make a commercial out of it because so articulate and so detailed, knowledgeable, and I knew whatever question he was going to ask here, I would have to kick to Neville because I can't understand a thing he says already, and I think he's 14 or so. But Kyle, thanks for being here, and thanks for your enthusiasm.
You want to go?
Yeah, we can both pile on. Your question supposes the answer. First of all, video is by far the most used data category on a mobile device, which is amazing. If you think about it, and John talked about how rapidly that has changed. It wasn't the case 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. So things have changed incredibly, and that's kind of why we're here addressing this issue today. Because to the other guys, as video consumption has taken off and binge watching has become the norm, they're seeing dollar signs. They're seeing a way to catch you in that catch-22, and either you're buying out of fear or you're buying too little and getting slammed with overages. We see a chance to do something radically different, make it way more efficient, and then pass that savings on to our customers. Just a difference in our philosophy. What else are they going to use it for? You're right, video and music are high on the list. Web browsing and a million apps are the things that, you know, that have dominated the data flows over the last couple of years. And maps are huge. They're very data intensive. I don't know what some of the other popular app categories are.
Facebook might be one, right?
Yeah.
So,
social
some
media,
big guys
and,
out there.
And, yeah. You know, we have some partnerships developing in the room. The world of the Internet of Things is going to require a data connectivity from so many components in your house, in your life, on your clothing, you know, that the scarcity of data will always be there. So I think if you look out 5 years, this will be one step in preparing for Internet of Things.
Okay, I just have one other question.
There you go.
Is Periscope maybe going to be on this? Because I just watch you all the time.
Interesting question. No. Thanks for being here, Kyle. Okay, anybody else? Yes.
Thank you. Mike Dana with Fierce Wireless. I have two quick questions. One is, can you talk about how the streaming technology works, if you used any specific vendors or technologies to make this streaming work? And then the second question, and I point out I wouldn't ask this at AT&T or Verizon event, but would you include porn services in this streaming?
Okay, well, I'll take that one. And that'd be yes. Yeah, no, of course. You know, importantly, no, I mean, it's a serious question. Any legal content, right, that meets the technical requirement will be brought in. Now, our company's kind of advertising and commercial relationship may vary, but yes, I mean, of course.
That's part of the spirit of net neutrality.
Yeah.
Do you have any?
Yeah.
Oh, just.
So no porn filters on the network implementation, right? But no. We've done a ton of work basically on the ingress points into the network, what we'd call our packet gateways. So where all of this content comes at us. And we've done work over a number of years, and much of it is unique to us. We're not going to disclose, you know, vendors and who we're working with on this. But it gives us the ability to identify video. And video is coming at us in many, many different formats today. And so the work that we've done on the packet gateways to ensure that, you know, if there's HTTPS coming at us, for example, we don't want to inspect the video. Is it porn or sports? We don't need to do that. But we actually need to know it's video. And so we've done a lot of work at the packet gateway level with our partners, with providers there, so that we can understand what is coming to the network. Is it in a video format? And then is it subject to what we want to do with Binge On? So it's a multi-year program, but we believe we have developed capabilities in our packet gateway platforms which are unique at this point in time.
Do you think AT&T would stop porn from being shown? Do you? Boy, I pray. I dare him to announce it. I would actually say on some of these topics, kidding aside, is, you know, the it's a glass houses question. If somebody thinks the standpoint of, you know, legal content of any kind being sourced and being shown, you know, let who's going to stand up and say that it's inappropriate, let me go through their surfing history for the last 2 years and check their cleanliness, and I'll start. Anyway, enough on the porn.
Last one, you spoke about the scarcity of data on that point. Earlier this year at the Deutsche Telekom Capital Markets Conference, you talked about what the competition can do with their spectrum, what Sprint doesn't know what to do with theirs, what AT&T can't do, what Verizon has done, what T-Mobile has done also to this point. You also talked about the spectrum auction next year, your pockets are packed, but you also conflated that against a debt burden that you perceived with Verizon. AT&T just blew a bunch of money at AWS-3 as well as DirecTV. How competitive is it going to be, and are you thinking you're actually going to dominate it, or will the incentive function come up short? Will the license holders hold back?
Let's just tick along that broad list. First of all, they're all full of shit. I mean, you know, in negotiation 101, you're going into an auction, make believe you're not interested, lower expectations so that you don't get inflated prices. So, you know, Francham, you know, we're not really sure. First it was, we don't know about the rules, we're not sure it's going to happen. Now it's, you know, I mean, it's kind of good for coverage, but it's not really good, and we don't really need that. That is yes, okay? That's yes, we're coming. AT&T's saying nothing. That's their version of complete, full, and open transparency. That means they're coming. Sprint, we're not coming. That's code for we're out of dough. And, you know, and Dad won't give us any more dough. And, you know, at least he bought a house in Kansas City, which last time I checked cost about $50,000. So it's not really a big investment in the company. And then, you know, of course, you got et cetera. You know, you've got the cable industry. And then you've got this 30 megahertz set aside, you know, which we think will be highly, highly beneficial. So for us, we see it as a big opportunity. By the way, we've been continuing to add to our 700 A-block portfolio as this arrives, so it's given us another opportunity. And we just see it as a once-in-a-lifetime low-band opportunity. We're going to be very prudent. You know, we're not going to go laying all sorts of money on the table. We've got a certain amount that we think is very prudent for our investors. And if that amount ends up being in an auction that nobody else shows up for, that will be one of the most historic moments in our company. And on the other hand, if you go all the way to the other side, and I'm always known as somebody, I will declare victory no matter what happens. because there's no real, let's suppose the biggest corporations in America show up and dump buckets of money on the table and clean the table. Okay, what are those implications in Washington? You know, what does that say about a four-carrier industry, et cetera, et cetera? You know, what does Dish do? You know, one of the shrewdest, you know, people who's really, you know, created havoc in auctions. But I don't see a bad outcome. But we're in pretty good shape as it is already. This is a 2020 game and beyond. So you should read mostly into it that we are so confident about the future of the company that we're investing heavily for what it's going to look like in the year 2021. You can ask him if Charlie's going to dump any money in over here.
Spill the beans, Red.
He'd lie to you too, though. Yes?
I did notice that Sling TV is here. Can you talk a little bit about Dish and its Spectrum war chest and whether you guys would make a deal with Dish directly for its Spectrum?
Listen, we've been in friendship with Dish at multiple levels, including Sling, for a long time. Charlie's kind of motherlode of Spectrum is, I think, anybody in this industry would almost have a fiduciary obligation to look at it and assess whether or not there's some way that you could utilize it in your business. And I think that's kind of where it stands. I think he's got a capability that he needs to do something with. And some of that could be that he participates in the industry directly or sells. And I've certainly told Charlie very directly before, if you're interested in doing a deal with T-Mobile, you know, come on over and talk to us. And if you're having a yard sale for your Spectrum, we're interested. I'm sure you got a really big house, and you know, in the yard it'll be, you know, don't just sit in the yard with Lowell. We'd be interested. But you know, why wouldn't you? The guy's got the mother load of Spectrum. Now, over the time that we talk with everybody, but over the time we've gotten to know Dish, we got to know Sling. And we got to know Sling TV, and we tested it and tried it, and we love it. And so there is a big statement that we're making here about offering to all of our customers at a discount Sling TV, because it's really slick. And it is one of the reasons why, you know, you can see an evolution of the future where these kind of industries start to come together.
So, John, when you were saying that none of the content providers are paying you guys for participation, nor are our subscribers paying to take part in Binge On, why isn't everyone part of Binge On, like, say, Facebook or YouTube?
Do you want to start?
Yeah, it's the technical challenge. So basically, we have to have a really good, as Neville was saying, reliable way to identify what's video and what's not. And a lot of services out there use technologies such as HTTPS, the security, or UDP, user data protocol, or other protocols that make it hard for us to disambiguate video from non-video. So we've got to be able to integrate. What we were able to do was identify some of the most popular services that either we could do it on our own, like we looked in and saw that we could identify Go90, DirecTV, et cetera, or we could do it through some collaboration and sharing of certificates, et cetera, so that we can see what's coming in that it's video. And that's all we want. You know, our doors are wide open.
So you want the content provider to tag it?
If it's secure, sometimes we need signatures from them.
Yeah. Right. We don't need to know what's in the tunnel. We just need to know it's video.
And remember, this was also a question that happened when we announced Music Freedom, like who's here, and then we laid out, and over time, virtually everybody, you know, met the ability for the identification, and some of it was a dynamic allocation that we couldn't see, and it's been corrected, and now they're in. I think it's over 95% of all. Yeah. You know, music streaming services are part of Music Freedom, and so day one, 24 is not bad. One more?
Hey, just a follow-up. Hey, Megan. Yeah. Just a follow-up question to Don, like, on a more general concept, like, how difficult or hard is it to make those technical requirements? And just a follow-up, if you're an unlimited data customer, or can you choose between this optimized 480 stream versus a 1080 stream, or, you know, high-quality stream?
Yep.
Yeah, it's, I mean, we've got a slew of partners that have found their way through our, you know, these technical requirements aren't difficult, Roger. So, I mean, look at the list that we've secured. Very straightforward. Yeah, very straightforward.
There's a list that we're publishing, but it all boils down to we need to be able to reliably know that it's video.
Smells like, looks like, is video. That's all we need.
And on your unlimited question, basically, as John said, this is all about user choice. And so a lot of our unlimited customers will look at this, and we expect the vast majority will look at this and say, no, it makes sense for me. More reliable video streaming, less buffering, you know, more consistent quality. Never touches my mobile hotspot bucket, which has now been doubled, so it'll always be there when I need it. A free movie rental from Vudu every month. Those are all benefits of leaving Binge On. Now, one thing we didn't point out is when people want to turn it off, the effect is immediate. And so if you've got a situation where for 2 hours you want to watch a two-hour movie using your mobile device, you can turn it off, watch that movie using your unlimited plan, and then turn it back on so that you don't waste data from your tethering bucket. The effects are immediate. And we would expect that behavior to be something that, you know, customers may do from time to time. But that's for, like, big screen viewing. You know, that's kind of why we put that tunnel out there. We wanted to tease everybody and show you today was about videos, if you didn't already know. But we also wanted to show you what that looks like when it's been optimized for a mobile screen. And it really is about giving people both. It's not about a trade-off, trading off quality for free. It's about getting both. A fantastic viewing experience that looks great, is reliable, is consistent, and that gives you either free or three times stretched video. And
see, as I was thinking about it last night, this is one of those announcements that will, you know, be like leftover food. I mean, it's going to get better every day you go back. And rather than fight about it, I think the issue we have here is that people will think of what's the gotcha, and there isn't. You know, there isn't one. And we'll go in, we'll try it, we'll like it for some application, not like it, turn it off, see that you can shift, switch, see what applications that they might want to watch at a higher resolution, and then factor into it the impact that whatever percentage you want, which I tell you, many, many people will be 100% of what they want to watch when they see the quality. And then you'll see that there's no gotcha, and what the impact is on pricing and data buckets is gigantic. And back to some of the technical questions, it can evolve. You know, technology can change and advance, and we can shift and change it. So it's as much as anything else, it's a concept that's got legs and has huge, huge impact. I think we're going to take one more question. I think yes.
Hi, my name is Thomas. I work for a German paper, Handelsblatt. Coming from Germany, so your largest shareholder, Deutsche Telekom, what they say about the plan?
We didn't really tell them. Yeah, I actually think they're on right now. So,
okay. I mean, it's great to get customers, but I mean, this seems to be not maybe the best interest of investors. So, what is your take?
Yeah, what I would say is this is actually incredibly good for investors. We are, like, everything we've done at T-Mobile, and we will have a separate set of meetings for investors. The profitability impact to us is gigantic in a positive sense, not only from a customer aggregation standpoint, but from an efficiency utilization of our network and the impact that it has. And so, trust me, all kidding aside, when I come up here and make a huge announcement, there's a business case associated that makes huge economic sense. And in this case, this is a gigantic positive, not just for customers, but for shareholders. So that'll be the piece we have to talk about. And DT is a very active shareholder, and early on in the process asked that very same question and got a satisfactory answer as the majority owner. So, but is everybody named Thomas? That's my only. Thomas Denenfeld, as you know, is the CFO of Deutsche Telekom and a huge supporter. So those are the questions, investor questions, and because you see this confusion now, the fear, uncertainty, and doubt out there in the Verizon world will be, shit, they're slowing it, you know, all that crap, that'll go on. But users will try this and love it. And investors will be scared, because it looks like T-Mobile's lighting a torch into a competitive wireless environment and or giving things away. And all I can say to that is, we're not that stupid. So, you know, let's spend the next few days really understanding it. And I think both investors and customers are going to be really happy. And this could be the biggest thing we've ever announced. So with that, we're going to, I think we're going to cut it off and go binge on. Appreciate your help.
Yeah, well done.
Good?